And there we go again. Interesting ideas. Always starts with a sounder. Now, I want to kind of vary it from time to time, and you will help me do that. And who am I? My name is Stan Houston. The program is Interesting Ideas, and we try to come to you just about every day, usually Monday through Friday, and then we have maybe one or two programs on the weekend. Sometimes we take the Sunday off because that's what we should do. And if we do have a program on Sunday, it's probably because it's an emergency or it's important or because we recorded it the day before. But the sounder reminds us just exactly what life is all about. It's meant to get your attention. And so we have a variety of ways of trying to do that. And one of them is just to remind you every time you hear that, here's what you need to know. Here's the interesting idea. Very simple, but very vital. You become what you pay attention to. Now think about that. You become what you pay attention to. Sounds simple, but it's really very difficult to do because most of us are so distracted by the stuff that comes into our life that we don't take time to be intentional about what we pay attention to, what we give our time to. We basically spend our time doing what we feel we have to do or whatever else happens to attract our attention that may not be necessarily worthwhile or helpful or useful, but we pay attention to it. So remind yourself, you become what you pay attention to. And that would be enough to just end this podcast. If you would just remember that in that 2 minutes. But I would like to point out a couple things that might be helpful. And of course, this is Monday, so you've been very, very, very busy. But I want to tell you a story that might be an encouragement to you. I discovered over the weekend, and it was one of those weekends. Well, I'll just be very blunt. It was a bit climatic and traumatic. My wife went through a major episode with a heart condition, and I'm glad she's still here, and I'm thankful to the doctors and the nurses and the ambulance drivers and the fire department who was there as first responders. I'm glad for all of those wonderful people who do that job, and they do it well. They have jobs totally unrecognized by most people, but they do important work. And I'm going to remind myself all of the time, and I'm going to remind you, is the work you're doing important? Not just important in the sense that it perhaps puts a paycheck or puts a obligation or responsibility, but is it important? Just think about that. Is the work I'm doing important? Pay attention to that. So, with that in mind, I press on. What I discovered is that one of the top podcasts, now, What It Takes Radio, Interesting Ideas is the work I do. I'm in the business of helping men and women increase their audience. And I have a video coming out. I did it just before the weekend on podcasting is about helping you reach your audience. Because if you want to be successful today, you have to have an audience. You can't just have a job. You have to have an audience. And we're going to tell you a little bit about how you do that. And podcasting is one of the primary ways to have an audience. It just so happened there's a very nice man. He's been in the priesthood for 20 years. He's tall and charming, you know, rather charismatic. You know, the kind of priest that would probably be able to handle it in a college setting at the University of Minnesota Duluth. And during the COVID crisis, he and his friend were looking for, what can we do? We got to keep busy. And so they decided to do a podcast, and they didn't make it, sexy or startling or attention-getting as we would probably coach them to do. In fact, if they came to me with the idea, I'm not so sure I would think it's a very good idea. But this is what they did. He read the Bible. That's right. He read the Bible with expression. Yes, he didn't just read it. He kind of performs it, which is what I would coach him to do. But he's just kind of a natural performer, and he reads the Bible, and then he says a prayer, and then he has a few words of encouragement. And what I would say, ACB, he always closes with a benediction, which is what you should do too. No matter what you do, always close with a benediction. And they've been doing that for a few years now, and they have the top podcast on Apple Podcast, averaging around 200 million listeners. Some of you perhaps in the Minnesota arena or some other areas may have heard the story, but just check out Father Mike Podcast, and boy, the links will come up, both the news reports about his success and some videos, YouTubes that he's done that have complemented that, where he talks about some of the things he does. And as a result, this man, who basically had an audience of maybe a few hundred students who cared enough at the University of Minnesota Duluth to pay attention to what he was about, he and his friend got together and they figure out a way to try to say, we'll read the Bible to people, and we'll go through the whole Bible and make it interesting as we can within a year, and we'll just simply say a prayer for people and close with a benediction. Who would have thought that that program would be one of the top podcasts around? Well, I would encourage you today, on this Monday evening, or perhaps Tuesday when you may be listening to this, find out. It may not be of interest to you, spiritually or religious, but you need to know that you can learn something from his success in reaching an audience. You need to figure out, as I'm trying to figure out, how did that happen? We think everyone's the heck with religion, the heck with this, the heck with that, and stronger words than heck, a lot of things. And who would think that in today's world that to read the Bible and pray on a podcast would attract millions of people? So that's an interesting idea for you to investigate. All right? So please think about that. Just another thought for this Monday. As I said, I went through a very difficult weekend, and I've gone through some very difficult times. I seem to attract them from time to time. But I also found out this word of encouragement. They said, if you want to have power, you know, this was an old wisdom book that I was reading called Streams in the Desert. It's over 100 years old. And the writer of this particular selection said, there is no power without pressure. If you'd like to have real power in your life, and as the commentator said, we all would like to have more power. We'd like to have greater power to do greater things, you know. Whatever the greater things might be, you know, what do we want? We want more power, or we want power to do things. We want to have all the stuff that goes into that. Remember that in the way the universe is constructed by a wise creator, the way you will gain power is because you flourish under pressure. You know, I remember that great line, the great line from probably my favorite film. And I think I've watched it 10 or 12 or 15 times, the Shawshank Redemption. When James Earl Jones makes that comment, he says, remember, a diamond is simply a piece of coal under great pressure for a long, long time. A diamond is simply a piece of coal under pressure for a long, long time. Perhaps the unnatural act we need to perform, and this finishes my 10 minutes of clarity for a Monday. Maybe we should be even thankful, as I'm trying to be. I'm thankful for the pressure. And I will remember that it is only when I'm under great pressure is that I will develop the power that I need to live well. No pressure, no power. Again, hopefully that'll sit on your head, stir your mind, move your spirit, and touch your heart. And with that in mind, I will also do this. As Jesus said when he was showing up after that time of his resurrection, he walked into people who were full of fear and said, I know you're full of fear. I know you're in pain. I know you're living in shame, but peace be with you. That's right. Peace be with you. And that's the ACB. That's the close. Always close with a benediction. Best and blessings to you. We'll be back with more interesting ideas every day. You join me. You share them with me. Please reach out to me and say, I want to be a part of this deal. StanHusted@gmail.com. StanHusted@gmail.com. And you start becoming a person with and sharing interesting ideas. Bye for now.